Dutch Sense here, 7:17 p.m. Central Time on Thursday, July 12th, 2012. And I'm over here on my Facebook page. I've been gone for the last 3 days, so I haven't been able to do any updates. Really busy, so it's good to get this out. I want to thank Territory for putting this alert out on the massive CME that occurred. And it was a X1.7. Let's go ahead and look at it. Now, this is a projection of the flare and where it's headed. Now, Earth is marked in yellow. And just watch the flare erupt, and you'll see it head directly towards Earth. The date and time stamp up here in the right-hand corner is progressing forward from today, showing you how long it could take for this shockwave to reach Earth. Now, what could be caused is, of course, aurora borealis occurring further south than we'd normally see it. Also, power grid failure, communications disruption, and possibly even large earthquakes and damaging storms a few days after or during this impact. Now, it is very large, and there's a couple different ways we can go look at it, all right? So I've pulled together several different links, and we'll go ahead and take a look at those. Now, here's the artist site, and I'll put this down below. It shows several different views of the sun, also the different charts. So we'll turn this off. Again, link down below for artists, and link down below for the projection. Now, also, while this is going on, we have severe weather occurring basically across the entire country again. So let's go ahead and turn on radar view for the U.S., and we'll also turn on National Weather Service alerts, Canadian Weather Service alerts, and Titan storm tracking. All right, and you can see it. Everything in blue is hail detected. Everything with a yellow box like this is damaging winds, and then the green is strong south thunderstorms. Canadian Service has multiple tornado warnings issued in central Canada, north of Edmonton, up in Alberta, and then heading southeast towards Saskatoon, a huge area that's having an outbreak right now. And then further east in Winnipeg, storms heading north by northeast in Winnipeg directly, and then further east, just west of Thunder Bay, going out into the backcountry of Canada. So we have Savant Lake, Ear Falls, Wabagoon, anywhere in that region there. And then further south in Minnesota, North Dakota, South Dakota, also extending south into Nebraska, Iowa, also Kansas. It also looks like even possibly into Missouri and Illinois. Strong south thunderstorms, also hail detected in a few of these storms. Now, in the southeast, the entire southeast, that would be South Texas, Louisiana, Arkansas, Alabama, Mississippi, Georgia, South Carolina, Florida, North Carolina, Tennessee, Kentucky, Virginia, West Virginia, Ohio, Pennsylvania, anywhere in this region here, strong south thunderstorms, damaging winds, and a few outbreaks of hail. Now, in the west, we have New Mexico, Arizona, Colorado, Utah, Nevada, California, Wyoming, Idaho, and even up into southwest Montana, strong south thunderstorms, damaging winds, and hail detected, with 2 to 3 different systems. Now, to see all that better, we'd have to go over to College of DuPage. Unfortunately, right now, their flash player is doing some really weird stuff. Can't look at it that way. So we're going to turn on the cloud cover this way. And the only difference is it's not as long and it's not as fast. So you can see it. We'll see different rotations here on these storms. And they're basically heading north by northeast. Each cell is heading north by northeast. And then down here in the southwest, it's actually still rolling off to the south-southwest. So we've got multiple systems at play that we need to watch for the next few days. That does not count the storm up here off the northwest and the 3 or possibly even 4 now forming tropical systems down here southwest of Mexico. We'll turn on the tropical tracks. We'll go ahead and turn on the cloud cover for the tropics. And so we have Amelia and Fabio. All right, so here's Hurricane Amelia, Category 2, headed west. And then Fabio is heading northwest right now. And it looks like the tracks are saying it's going to go back to the northeast. So we're going to have to watch these two systems here. So let me go ahead and animate this up. And if you live in Hawaii, be aware these are heading your general direction. And if you're in watercraft of any kind, that it's going to be rough seas anywhere out here, okay? And that would include in Baja, Mexico, and in Southern California. Now, finally, let's just take a quick look at the earthquakes for the last 3 to 4 days. Here's the last 4 days, and you can see the tremendous amount of movement that's occurred. Puerto Rico, Central America, South America, going up the west coast, a series of 4.0s, going west all the way across Alaska, going down through Japan, swarms of 4 and 5.0 earthquakes, from New Zealand through Vanuatu, can't pronounce that ever. And then west all the way through Indonesia and ending in Sumatra, we have a series of 4 and 5.0 earthquakes. Now, again, dead zone, India. No large earthquakes in India in a very long time, so we need to watch India going west towards Europe again. I would say watch South Europe, okay? It's been at least a month now since we've seen a very large earthquake in Italy, and there are going to be follow-ups after that large movement that occurred about a month and a half ago. All right, folks, so it's been a wild and wacky past week. I'll tell you what, it really has been severe weather every day in the same spots, hail and damaging winds each day, every day. And that's going to carry on into the future. We're going to see it probably carry on like this at least for the next several weeks as this pattern just keeps hold. So if you guys get any confirmations on the hail or any kind of footage or anything like that, put it down below the video. And have a plan and be prepared, because it could happen in the middle of the night when those damaging winds or hail comes through. Make sure your car is pulled in, make sure your pets are taken care of, your livestock's put away, because you never know how big this hail could get. Also, tornadoes can come down at a moment's notice, sometimes without any warning at all. All right, folks, much love and expect more updates. I'll be trying to get it out as much as possible. Again, I've been working two jobs now, so man, I'll tell you what, in 105 degree heat, guys, it's wild. Be safe and much love, okay? Cheers.